Here with our women's basketball weekly update with head coach Aaron Johnston. Let's recap the two games last week to begin. Lost to USD. You had that lead into the fourth quarter, played a good 35 minutes. They came back, kind of made a few more plays, and at the free throw line were able to take the lead, and you couldn't quite close it out down there.
Yeah, it was a tough one for us. I thought we played really well throughout the game, but just couldn't quite find a way to finish it in the last few minutes. Offensively, played really well for 35 minutes. Shot the ball effectively. We got good looks. Then the last couple of minutes, their defense tightened up, and they made some shots. So they deserve a lot of credit for that. Going through the conference year undefeated is a tough thing, and they earned it. But I do think our team played well enough to win. We just didn't quite get it done. So it was time to move on and get ready for the next one.
Was there any concern after that with such a tough loss, deflating, played so well early on, or how did the team respond after that?
I don't think the team was shaken to the point where it was hard to get up for the Fort Wayne game. They're disappointed, just like they are after every loss. That's the great thing about having a team that's really confident and believes in themselves and has a lot of talent. They expect to win. And when that game didn't work the way we wanted, having a game after that that we had to get ready for was actually a good thing. And I thought they shifted gears and focused really well. Had we gone down there and just really laid an egg and not played well, that might have been something that was different. But since we played so well and had some chances to get it done, I think there are a lot of positives that the team could draw on.
You talked about the Fort Wayne game, a game of just taking care of business, kind of methodical 22-point win out there in Fort Wayne, and ended the regular season on a high note.
I did a great job at Fort Wayne, not only bouncing back after the tough one, but we just played really well. Shot the ball well. We had great balance. Maya had another real good game, so she continues to play well coming back from her injury. Macy was really solid. Then after that, we were just really balanced. Nobody really had a big monster game. Everybody just kind of contributed, did a nice job on both sides, offensively and defensively. So a great way to finish off an exceptional regular season for us. Feel really good about what happened throughout the year, and certainly something that gives us some confidence and momentum going into the conference tournament.
12-2, like you said, 23-6 and overall. Didn't get that regular season title, but I imagine that's almost got to be a motivating factor here as you enter tournament time.
Yeah, they're really separate things. I think our team is disappointed not winning a regular season championship. That's a goal, and it's a goal for us every year. And when it doesn't happen, I know we're disappointed. To your point, it might serve as a little bit extra fire as we go down to Sioux Falls for a different event, the conference tournament. And what we always tell our team, no matter where we are in this event, anything that happened in the regular season really doesn't matter now. You have to assume you're going to get everybody's best game. You have to assume they're going to be tight and difficult. But you also have to assume we're going to play our best game, and our level is going to improve as we get down there. So it really is a whole different atmosphere. You just figure out a way to try and win that first game and move on to what comes next.
It really is one of the best women's basketball tournaments in the country, whether it's the facility or the crowd or the atmosphere. It really is one of a kind down there in Sioux Falls.
Yeah, the facility is really like no other. It's just a beautiful venue, not only for us, but for fans. So that has a lot to do with the experience. But then the atmosphere, the attendance, really like no other in women's basketball. The atmosphere, the emotion, the energy, nothing really compares to it. And then the student athletes feel that too. So it really has become an event people, plan out months in advance, and this year's tickets or next year's tickets will go on sale here in the next couple of days. So it's really become a pretty special thing, and I know our team will be ready for it.
Look at the bracket. You'll start out Saturday afternoon with NDSU as the seventh seed, a team you really handled very well up in Fargo a few weeks ago, but they're going to look at it as a clean slate and a new season for them as well.
Yeah, both those games, the final score was a widespread, but they were both closer than maybe sometimes the score dictated. There were times in those games where we had a difficult time matching up with them. They really spread you out with their motion offense. They score late in possessions. They do a good job of being really versatile, meaning there's not one or two players that score for them. So both games were difficult, and we had to play pretty well. So we'll have to try and improve from where we were in those first two.